CNN Boston Common is buried in white. Manhattan is breathing a sigh of relief. Parts of the New England coastline are being whipped by near-hurricane force winds and waves. Welcome to the blizzard of 2015. We're hunkered down with food, shelter and water, said Rafi Manacham, the financial consultant who lives in Brookline, Massachusetts, near Boston. I'm worried about electricity. Manacham's wife is a doctor at Boston Medical Center. She's sleeping at work and won't be back home until Wednesday, maybe later. Even weather-toughened New Englanders are paying attention to this storm. You almost have to when the National Weather Service is throwing out terms like crippling and potentially historic when talking about it. Just a bit to the south, New York City looked nothing like its normal bustling self early Tuesday. Schools are closed, and city officials shut down public transit. It cleared the roads and let snow plows do their jobs. The forecast snow is falling 2 to 4 inches an hour at times and is especially heavy along the coast. Conditions eased in New York and New Jersey early Tuesday, as the National Weather Service discontinued the blizzard warning for most of those two states. Folks can still expect blizzard conditions from eastern Long Island, New York, to Maine. The forecast also improved a bit for Boston, which was originally expecting up to 30 inches of snow. It's now expecting 15 to 25 inches, and in some cases a bit more. Up to 58 million people could be put into the deep freeze. And the storm could have a far-reaching economic impact, even beyond the region directly hit. States of emergency are in place in 7 states across the region: Massachusetts, New York, New Jersey, Connecticut, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, and New Hampshire. The impact flying into and out of the Northeast is a non-starter. More than 4,500 flights have been canceled for Tuesday, the flight tracking website FlightAware.com said. That's on top of 2,800 scrubbed Monday. Hundreds more have already been canceled for Wednesday. The hardest hit airports were in New York, Boston, and Philadelphia. Boston's Logan Airport won't reopen until Wednesday. The major United States airlines are offering fee-free rebooking of flights to and from the Northeast through Tuesday. For some travelers, it was touch and go. Ricardo Canadenhaus looked through an ice-coated window on his Virgin Atlantic flight before takeoff. He could barely see. Number sign is the safe, he tweeted. Amtrak said it was suspending Northeast Regional and ACLA Express services between New York and Boston for Tuesday because of severe weather. Other Amtrak train routes in the region will operate at reduced frequencies, the rail line said. The road said is no joke to have people stranded on a highway. We've gone through that before, New York Governor Andrew Cuomo told reporters Monday. It is frightening how quickly a simple trip to the supermarket can wind up being very dangerous. Connecticut and Massachusetts also put travel bans in place. Violating the ban can set you back $500 in Massachusetts. In Philadelphia, Mayor Michael Nutter declared a snow emergency. Cars left parked on snow emergency routes will be towed and owners ticketed, he said. It's going to be the kind of night where the best thing anybody can do is stay inside, Massachusetts Governor Charlie Baker said Monday evening. The reaction the storm warnings seemed to impress even the most jaded Northeasterner. Groceries flew off store shelves from Brooklyn to Bangor. Michelle Thompson, a professor who lives in New York, found little left at a Greenwich Village grocery store. These are the sorts of supplies New Yorkers need, she said, gazing at the empty shelves. Apparently, fresh bread is imperative, as well as eggs. Don't forget the dried pasta and sauce. It was the same story at the Star Market, where Manacham shops in Boston. The majority of the produce, deli meats, eggs, milk and bread were all gone, he said.